If I asked you what your favorite cinematic universe is, you'd probably say... Which makes sense. Over the last decade, Marvel has built an impressive roster of interconnected movies that have consistently been pretty entertaining. But the MCU isn't the only game in town. You could also say the view is Skewniverse, which contains the Kevin Smith movies with Jay and Silent Bob, and actually have more links than you might think.
Hey, you know what Sanford told me?
I can't believe Caitlin's getting married.
Julie Doyer died.
Yeah, right.
No, I'm serious. Embolism in her brain yesterday.
Jesus.
She was swimming in the pool in the YMCA when it happened. She died mid-backstroke.
T.S., did you see Julie Dwyer last night?
Yeah, I saw her at the video store.
She went straight up to the YMCA and just started doing laps. In the middle of her 700th lap, this embolism popped in her brain and she dropped dead. Right in mid-backstroke.
Catching a bus to Chi-Town.
Why? What's there?
Business, yo.
Jersey's pretty far from McHenry. May I ask what brought you here?
Some fuck named John Hughes. We could live like fat rats if we were the Blunt Connection in Sherman, Illinois. So we collected some money we owed and caught a bus. But you know what the fuck we found out when we got there? There is no Sherman in Illinois. Movies are fucking bullshit.
Then there's Universal. No, not the abject failure of the Dark Universe. I'm talking the original monster movies made from the 1930s through the 1950s. Continuity's a bit fast and loose, but hey, the movies rule and they definitely share a similar aesthetic. Speaking of horror, you might even argue that Freddy Krueger and Jason Voorhees share a universe, though that might be more of a stretch. Outside of the crossover film, the only connection is this brief moment from Jason Goes to Hell, The Final Friday, a movie where Jason does not go to hell and is not The Final Friday. Needless to say, you have a lot of worthy choices, but what the coolest of cool kids know is that the Jacques Demy cinematic universe is the best one of all. Who exactly is Jacques Demy?
Nous sommes des sœurs jumelles, nées sous le signe des Gémeaux. Mi fa sol la mi ré, ré mi fa sol 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 ré do.
One of the emergent voices of the French New Wave and the husband of Agnès Varda, Jacques Demy had an all too brief run directing movies from the early 1960s through to the late 1980s. A major figure of the Nouvelle Vague, Demy is distinct from many of his New Wave peers, in part because his main American influences weren't gangster movies, Alfred Hitchcock, and film noir, but Hollywood musicals of the Gene Kelly variety, and in part because Demy didn't just make movies, but constructed his own cinematic world, where the hero of one movie might pop up for a supporting role in another. The universe comprises six films in particular: Lola, Bay of Angels, The Umbrellas of Cherbourg, The Young Girls of Rochefort, Model Shop, and Un Chambre en Ville. Let's run through the connections. We start with Lola, which ends with the titular burlesque performer leaving Nantes with her lover Michel. 8 years later, Demy would return to Lola in Model Shop, now living as a single mother in LA after Michel ran off with a woman named Jackie. The very same Jackie, whose gambling addiction fueled the plot of Demy's Bay of Angels.
17 Noir Impériment.
Back when Lola was in Nantes, she was romanced by Roland Cassar, a young man who gets swept up in a diamond smuggling scheme and whom Lola ultimately rejects.
Au revoir.
We next see Roland in The Umbrellas of Cherbourg, now a very successful jeweler in Paris. He attempts to court the melancholic Genevieve, still deeply in love with her boyfriend Guy, serving in Algeria. Roland eventually confides his rejection by Lola, and Demy even takes us back to the passage Pomeray we spent so much time at in Lola. From here, the universe gets a little shaky. Demy wanted to bring back Guy as one of the carnies in The Young Girls of Rochefort, but had to scrap those plans when Nino Castelnuovo was unavailable. And that might have been for the best, given the ending of Cherbourg is just perfect. Young Girls does seem to reference Lola as the victim of an axe murderer stalking Rochefort, but the character is described as being far older than the Lola from Demy's film. Plus, that Lola is very much alive in Model Shop, so yeah. So it would seem there's no connections drawn in The Young Girls of Rochefort. But maybe there is. It's worth noting that the towns Demy's previous films were set, Nantes, Nice, and Cherbourg, are all mentioned in dialogue in The Young Girls of Rochefort, with some characters even talking about how they used to live there. Normally, that wouldn't imply much, but given all of Demy's films prior were part of a shared world, it's hard not to see these references in a similar light. Nantes isn't just a city in France. It's the place where Roland's heart was broken. Nice was the setting for Jackie and Jean to indulge in their gambling addiction. And Cherbourg was where Guy and Genevieve lived their brief but unforgettable romance. That's maybe a stretch, but my mind can't help but fill with such imagery. The only other reference to Demy's cinematic universe, at least that I'm aware of, would come in the early 80s with En Chambre en Ville, where the name of a minor character from Lola is scribbled on the wall. Now this is obviously pretty tenuous, but that might be part of the point, with the romantic optimism of Lola feeling a distant memory and the harsh political climate here. So other than the inherent fun that comes from seeing these intertextual references, what did these films actually gain from being connected? What did Demy do with his cinematic universe? Quand l'été a disparu, l'été. Well, first, I think it's important to stress what he didn't do, which is that he didn't let it become a stylistic or narrative trap. Where other universes, from the classic monsters to the MCU, tend to follow a repeated visual style and basic plot beats, there's a ton of variety in Demy's universe. We can immediately draw a clean split between Demy's large-scale musicals, The Umbrellas of Cherbourg, The Young Girls of Rochefort, and Chambre en Ville, and his more intimate dramas, Lola, Bay of Angels, Model Shop. But even within these categories, we can make further divides. Lola and Bay of Angels feel very much at peace with the French New Wave, with their low-tech, black-and-white cinematography and on-location shooting. To quote film professor Jeanette Vincendu, at once documentary and lyrical. Model Shop, meanwhile, is very much an outsider's perspective of LA, most comparable to Varda's take on the city in Lion's Love and Lies. Further still, while Lola is more of an ensemble piece, Bay of Angels is hyper-focused on its two leads, to the point of being sparse in anything else. It would also be a mistake to assume the Jacques Demy musical looked like one thing. Where The Umbrellas of Cherbourg is a deeply melancholic look at young love and the bittersweet pull of adulthood, The Young Girls of Rochefort is a joyous celebration of romance and wonder, bursting at the seams with color and beauty. Not to mention that Umbrellas and En Chambre en Ville are recitative musicals, where every word is sung, while Rochefort more conventionally separates its dialogue and musical numbers. That difference has pretty tangible effects. While the blocking in Umbrellas and En Chambre is precisely controlled to accommodate the ambitious soundtrack, Rochefort is all about the vibrancy of movement. If these movies are about singing, La direction a décidé ce matin. This one's about dancing. And even the recitative musicals are really different. Love is lost and found in En Chambre en Ville, as in all Demy films, but it's in the distant background, behind workers' strikes and political revolution. Umbrellas of Cherbourg, on the other hand, exists in a more romantic space. Clearly, Demy wasn't making the same movie over and over again, and yet, there is something of a continuing story in these films. The recurring appearances of Lola are probably the clearest example of this, but I actually find Roland's story even more powerful. Ignoring his character in Lola, Roland plays a pretty simple role in The Umbrellas of Cherbourg. The boring but wise marriage choice which represents Genevieve choosing economic responsibility over youthful romance. She still loves Guy, but she has to let him go. And that story works. You don't need to see Lola for this to resonate. But if you have seen Lola, then you recognize this marriage as Roland's tragedy too. He doesn't really love Genevieve, just as she doesn't really love him. For both characters, their union is a compromise because neither could get what they really wanted. Along with Model Shop, both films examine the consequences of Lola's choice to reject Roland from Michelle. One can't help but imagine how different things could have been had Lola chosen differently. Not just for Lola and Roland, but maybe for Guy and Genevieve too. And that sense of consequences rippling outward is the other element of the Jacques Demy cinematic universe I find so intriguing. Demy movies are all about the collision between choice and chance. As Jonathan Rosenbaum calls it, the unending struggle in Demy's work between blind chance and overdetermined control. We see it in the way characters crisscross in and out of each other's lives in Lola, or in how Jackie and Jean give themselves over to gambling in Bay of Angels. We see it in the wandering strangers of Model Shop, or in the fractured ensemble of En Chambre en Ville, or the constant romantic near misses in The Young Girls of Rochefort.
Salut!
And of course, we see it in The Umbrellas of Cherbourg. and the enchanted young lovers torn apart by war and economic hardship. Demi is constantly reminding us how individual choices compound with chance, and how happiness and heartbreak are always just a step away. And that's why his shared universe is so important. Characters and stories don't just exist in a vacuum, but are part of a larger world of possibility. A world where strangers are interconnected by fate, and where the full ramifications of a choice take years to really manifest themselves. Even when direct crossover is minimal, we're always aware in a Jacques Demy movie that the story and characters are just a tiny fraction of a world bursting with possibility. The work of a quirky new wave director might seem pretty far removed from our current understanding of the cinematic universe, but I think there's a lot to learn from Demy. One of the most common criticisms of Marvel, despite a generally consistent batting average, is that all of their movies kind of feel the same. Despite technically offering a massive universe of intergalactic scale, the MCU is also a limitation, a box for films to fit within. What Jacques Demy's universe shows us, in their sheer range and thematic emphasis on chance and possibility, is how a cinematic universe can expand rather than contract. And that, my friends, is a lesson worth learning.
Nous serons d'autres femmes.